Hi, this is Mr. Anderson, and this is part two of Adams and Elements. In part one, I talked about the history of the atom and how in this one, I'm going to talk about what do we got.
No, Alice, you can't help me. You don't have me alone. We have friends. I don't know him. You must be relying. I think you're
so this is more of a relying. In other words, what do you learn from looking at the periodic table? On the periodic table, you have essentially a box, and that box represents one.
I know, isn't
that
right?
It represents one type of element, and so we'll call this neon right here. So neon's a gas, it's a noble gas, and if you put it inside a tube, and electricity through, it's going to glow.
Yeah, you can!
But what do we know from this 10, this 20, this 2, this 8? What does that tell us? And so, essentially what we're looking at is the periodic table.
Now we have one more minute. Number 4 answer.
So the atomic number is going to tell us the number of protons.
Maybe I don't have me a little bit.
What else does the atomic number tell us? It also tells us the number of electrons. Because the positive charge is the protons, and the negative charges of the electrons equal each other out. The next thing we have is the mass number. So the mass number, the mass of an electron is really, really small. It doesn't weigh much. And so the mass number tells us the mass or the number of protons we have plus the number of neutrons that we have. Okay, so what are protons? Those are positive charges. What are neutrons? They're the same as protons, but they have a neutral charge.
No.
And then what are electrons? Electrons are going to have a negative charge.
I don't know.
But again, they're going to
be around the
atom. So let's kind of do one of these. I'm going to use the Bohr model right now, and so this is not really what an atom looks like, but we'll get more specific a little bit later. And so let's start in the middle. So this is going to be the nucleus right here. So if we look at this up here, neon, the 10 at the top, so that's how the periodic table is organized. The 10 at the top is going to tell us how many protons it has.
I'm sorry,
let's say it's got 10 positive charges on the inside. Next one. This is the average atomic mass. And so if you're going to solve one of these, they have to tell you what the mass number is. But let's say the mass number, for example, of neon is 20. What does that mean?
You're welcome.
Well, there's 10 protons, and there's also going to be 10 neutrons. So on the inside, we're going to say that there are 10 neutrons on the inside. Because the number of protons and the number of neutrons always add up to the mass number. Okay, now let's figure out the number of electrons. Well, there's something that you should remember, and I'm going to write this up at the top. That is 2, 8.
Isn't it right? There's only a spring.
18. Yeah, it keeps going like this, but for now, let's just remember that. 2, 8, 18. In other words, the electrons always go in specific energy levels. Okay, so let's go back to it again. So we've got 10 protons in here, so how many electrons do we have? Well, we have 10 electrons.
I don't know, that's the charge going to
be the same.
What?
But those electrons always fill their way up from the inside to the outside. So what does that mean?
What the?
We have 10 electrons in this first
What's going on? Stop right there!
Taking care of 10, now we only have 8 electrons. How many can I put in the next level? Well, this is why I said you really want to remember this at the top. Well, I can put 8 electrons in the next level. I'm going to say 8 electrons in the next level. Now we'll learn in later chapters.
Yeah, you can. Block this next and a corner and block it up for you.
Electrons are happy if this energy level is filled, or atoms are happy if it's filled.
Okay, so we have four electrons now. Everyone's four. Did not actually. Everyone's in the 90s. There's 2,000 everyone's square.
So that's a lot of stuff. Let's see what we can remember. Let's do something like nitrogen. Okay. Nitrogen makes up most of what you're breathing right now. So let's go through it. So if you look at it, our atomic number is 7. So how many protons does it have?
I don't
have 7 protons. How many neutrons does it have? Well, let's round this for a second, because this is the average. And so let's say that it's 14. So if that's 14 as a mass number, that means we have 7 neutrons.
Okay, everybody, you stay tight.
So let's say this is our nucleus. Now let's do electrons. Well, there are 7 electrons, and so you're going to put 2 electrons in the first level. You're going to put it like that.
This bell has me alone.
Draw this first energy. And so I've taken care of 2 of those.
Okay, everybody, you're getting here.
How many are in the next level?
I'm talking about it. I don't know. Isn't it right?
So it looks like that.
MFBO.
electrons.
What's me?
But there's five electrons in there. And now you're starting to see why we have these numbers a lot of the time on a periodic
or
table.
Or can't help it longer.
So what is nitrogen want?
Well, isn't it right here? Well, I got to remember one even better. Whoever's sweet too. But travel, there's not telling me.
Else, so this is
you saw something. Right. Oh, and your twilights and the rainbows.
Ammonia is NH3. And so that's one nitrogen atom and three hydrogens. And so eventually in the next few chapters, we'll start talking about chemical bonds. And so what hydrogen can actually offer to nitrogen is those three electrons it can share.
Well,
and so you should be able to do that with any kind of an atom on the...